you know if we put a high vis on, can you spare two minutes? Please.
We're not allowed.
What about your manager?
I don't think the manager is allowed.
Can't let you on the premises, mate.
We'll sign in. Visitors book.
They're not allowed.
Hi everybody, PJ here, and today we're at a company called Lifestyle Floors. Now I do believe, according to some of the posters on the fences I've walked around here, that they do artificial grass as well, which is something that some of the floor covering people do. I know they do it at the carpet place at Doncaster. Can't remember what it's called now, but who cares anyway. So myself and DJ are going to have a wander around and see what we can see.
Who do you watch, him or me?
See you then.
Him? There you go then, watch one of your key rings, mate.
DJ.
Which one's which?
You're PJ, right?
I am PJ.
Which one are you?
DJ.
DJ, yeah.
There you go, there's one of them. What was your first name?
John.
John, nice to meet you, John. Yeah. Are you a driver here, are you?
No, I'm not.
Oh, just a haulier.
Here you go.
Thank you.
So you're taking the stock from here to where?
No, I'm leaving the stock here.
Oh.
All of different companies.
Also, these buy the carpet in. So the goods that you're delivering is not carpet. Flooring. So boxes of laminate sort of thing.
Got Are you going after this?
Just staying around the area. You got any suggestions?
I don't really know the area. You know.
Right, okay.
Where have you come from?
Me, I live in Liverpool.
From where? Oh, you've had a good drive then?
Yeah, for 5 minutes.
Yeah, well, and it's motorway nearly all the way, isn't it?
When do you use your poster stuff? How long can you post it?
Oh, it depends how good looking people are that are on it. You know, I mean, if we get good looking people, we try and post it really quick. Yeah, but if we get ugly looking people, it's, sometimes they don't go on, do they?
It goes to the back of the queue.
Yeah, it goes to the back of the queue, yeah.
Based?
Sorry?
Where are you based?
Leicester.
Leicester and Worksop.
Do you make good money out of posting stuff?
Not enough.
Do you get paid for the advertising,
yeah? Yeah.
It's like per 1,000 views, you've got an amount. So everybody's got to watch an advert, and you get a few pence from that.
You don't even get a few pence, do you?
But what they're hoping is that advert you watch, you then go and buy that product. And there's always a small chance that you will see the advert, and it will influence you next time you're in the supermarket, you might buy that product, yeah? So that's what they're hoping for. And they give us a few pence for that risk. You know, the risk, the chance that somebody might go on and buy it, that's worth a few pence to them.
It all depends on the time of year as well. In November and December coming up to Christmas, you make a lot more money because a lot more people wanting to advertise and people are fighting for advertising places. In January, everybody spent their advertising budget, and it goes down to like something like £1 per 1,000 views, which is not a lot. If you think that, like,
at least you're making money on it.
Yeah. Are you considering it then? Are you doing it yourself?
Me, no.
Right.
I'm starting my own firm.
You're starting your own haulage firm?
I drive past one thing. Just pull containers.
Sorry, mate. It's a bit.
So I'm buying my own unit.
Oh, brilliant.
In Germany.
What, a rigid?
No, the class one driver is usually well. Someone's off today.
Do you know how to make a small fortune in haulage?
No.
Start off with a large one.
What do you mean?
Just lose money, mate.
Yeah, good,
yeah, I've done it. Been there. Yeah, packed it in. I couldn't get drivers I could trust. Constantly hassled by police and pulled over. You know, get in here, let's inspect your vehicle. All sorts of things all the time.
Well, I was just going to buy a second-hand unit, and I was looking at the auction from Germany for a trailer.
Yeah.
It was about 17,000. But I'm not sure what the short track costs, but you're getting about 900,000 for the same amount, depending on price.
Yeah, but your old license costs you a fortune. I mean, when I got mine, I think it was like 5.5 grand plus 2,000 or 3,000 per vehicle on top of that. So your old license is going to cost you 8 grand before you even start. Then you've got to have somewhere to keep your vehicle that is approved. You can't keep it on your drive, you can't keep it on the street, it's got to be an approved site. And then on top of that, you've got to have a service plan. It has to go in every 8 weeks for its maintenance and you know, and stuff like that. And in, you know, my goods insurance, goods in transit insurance was over £1,000 a week.
Wow.
Yeah. But I was carrying high value goods. I'd got meat and stuff like that. So you think 17 tonner full of best steak, there's a lot of money on there. But yeah, it was over £1,000. I can't hear you, mate. So.
Into it really, hopefully.
Yeah.
Did you have any confrontation today?
Started, okay. So people have been behaving.
Only with each other. And somebody in the toilet at McDonald's.
Yeah, Uber driver.
Like a
sitting in the toilet for too long.
Didn't want to, he thought it was his own toilet.
Anyway, nice to meet you, my friend. We'll let you crack on.
What's your name again?
John.
John. Alright, John.
Pleasure to meet you, John. The video will be on in about a week's time. Take care, mate.
Yeah, I would never ever go back into doing haulage again.
Well, if there's anybody that can give him advice, it's certainly you. You've been there, done that.
I have.
But for him to actually consider going into it on his own with one small vehicle, with all those overheads that you mentioned.
Yeah.
You must have a lot of promised work.
I started off with a 3.5 ton fridge vent. That's what I started off with. And worked my way up from there.
Well, we can see the forklift over there, look. We've just been loading some flooring onto this trailer here. Now, PJ, do you know how those have got little openings on the side?
Yeah.
Is that just like a little door at the front, or does the whole side slide?
I do suspect it slides both ways. So the front section will slide back and the back section will slide forwards, if you know what I mean.
And do they have a particular name? Because I've not seen them before.
Well, they're just demountable trailers.
Right.
But it's just a variation on a demountable trailer. Okay. The beauty of these is the trailer can be here and it can be getting loaded while another trailer is on the back of a vehicle doing deliveries.
Yeah.
So you don't have to have the vehicle stood while it's getting loaded. It's like having an Arctic where you can drop a trailer off and pick another trailer up that's fully loaded and off you go. So these work similarly. You know, you can drop a trailer off that's empty, pick one up that's loaded, and away you go. You don't have to sit there like something like this vehicle and wait for it to be loaded.
So the type of vehicle that would have dropped that off and picked it up then, is it like one of these roll on, roll off, skip type of things?
That's one there, look. That's them there.
Which, this first one?
Yeah, these are the same look.
What, so that's the demountable back?
It looks like it from here.
That's a rigid, mate.
Yeah, but they have demountable bodies on rigids. It's a bit hard to see from here.
I wonder if the gentleman will let us get closer, we can have a look at that.
Let me zoom in, see if there's any... If there's legs on it, it's a demountable cab, and if not...
I can't see any legs. Maybe that one at the end.
The end, yeah, yeah. Yeah, that one at the end's possibly a demountable. No, then those first three aren't, but that end one.
Yeah,
if you look, it's the same size and shape as these that's on the loading bay here, look.
Yeah, and it's got that piece of steel at the bottom of it.
Yeah.
For it to slide on and off the chassis.
Yeah.
Okay, so the vehicle would look like that then.
Yeah. Right. So unless you look at them really close up, it's hard to tell.
Here's a helpful gentleman coming now, so he might tell us more.
It might do.
Alright, mate.
Yeah, you?
Yeah, not bad. Alright.
Yeah.
The vehicle at the end. One second.
Is that demountable?
Huh?
Wait while the gate's done.
Are you auditors?
One sec. When this opens, we'll talk to you properly because it's very important.
Extremely.
I know, I see you on YouTube.
Yeah, what's my name?
I know you.
You don't get a key ring.
You don't get, that's it. If you don't know my name, you don't get a key ring.
I'm sure I see you on YouTube.
I'll give you a clue, it starts with P.
PJ?
PJ, yes, you've got me.
Hello.
What's your name?
I watch all of you.
What's your name?
My name is Peter.
Your name is Peter, there you go.
I knew it.
Yes, Tesh Polsky?
No, Romanian.
Romanian?
Yeah.
Okay.
Peter, do you know the vehicle at the end? Has that got a demountable body on it?
Same as these here.
Yes.
Yeah, it looks like it.
The others, they're fixed, aren't they?
No, they're all the same.
They all demount?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you able to just give us 1 minute and show
us? No, I'm not allowed.
Right, okay. What do you do here?
Carpets.
No, what do you personally do?
Me, I'm a forklift truck driver.
And does the forklift go inside the middle of the carpet, or?
Yes, they do.
Do they clamp the side?
No, in the middle of the carpet.
So you've got a long...
See all the tubes there?
Yeah.
On that bin. Them, obviously, them with broken tubes.
You look like a narwhal then, when you're driving around with the big long thing sticking out.
How
long? Or me on Viagra.
How long is the forklift
3.5 meters.
Really?
Yeah.
So your aisles then need to be at least that wide. At least 3.5 meters wide. Do you know if we put a high vis on, can you spare two minutes? Please.
We're not allowed.
What about your manager?
I don't think the manager allowed
you. Can't let you on the premises, mate.
We'll sign in, visitors book.
They're not allowed. Can't help.
Right, okay.
You do artificial grass here, don't you?
Yes.
Are you okay if we take the drone over and have a look ourselves?
Go ahead, because you're allowed anyway.
Perfect.
So,
all good.
I know all of them, so I cannot argue with you.
Yeah.
You know, we're putting them off TikTok.
Yes.
Yeah.
So the grass that you sell here, it's not the smoking type.
No, but you have to dry it.
DJ Audits, yeah.
What's your name?
Jordan.
Nice to meet you, mate.
I've seen you on TikTok.
There you go, you see. And who am I? Oh, there you go, you don't get a keyring then.
We know Martin Bragbra and AB.
Oh, you've met them before?
Yeah.
What, here?
Charlie Beach, no, here.
But you've met them?
Yeah.
Wow. Not even I've met AB, so you've met someone that I haven't.
I've not met AB.
Oh.
I did. There was in Widdershore with Martin Bragbra.
Oh, I need your autograph, I think.
Anyway, we have
I need the keyring back if he's my AB.
He's got an AB keyring, mate.
I don't think AB gives them out, does
no,
he?
No, it doesn't.
I don't know.
It's crazy, I never thought I'd see you in somewhere like this.
Why?
There was been all of them within your police station, so there I see them. There wasn't live video, so I drove, go straight away there.
Yeah, we're all over. And no industrial estate is safe, is it?
What area was the live video in that you met them?
Martin Blackburn was live video on YouTube.
Is it Ashton Underline, that
one? No, Withinshore Police Station.
Withinshore?
Yeah.
Ah, yes. Did you feature on his video?
No.
Right, you stayed off shot.
Yeah.
Right, you're going to be on this one, you know.
Good.
Your claim to fame, finally.
Yeah. You'll have all the women chasing you.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I don't need them.
No, neither do I, mate.
Before we go, we're going to hide a keyring somewhere. So when the video comes out, shortly after, it might not be 4 o'clock. So around between four and six, no, in a week's time.
Okay.
You'll get lots of people coming here looking for the key ring.
Good.
And they'll be looking for you, the good looking one. Okay, mate. Yeah, we're out the way. But thanks for the information. So all of them are demountable.
Yes.
Right. Quite unusual for us to see them, you know. Do you know the side of the trailer? Swap.
It looks like only one side slides.
It goes up and down. So that one over there, that's the same, up and down.
Yeah, all of them the same.
All the same.
Yeah, so it doesn't look like the back end slides at all, does it? Just like the front end.
The two sides open up as well.
Yeah, I mean the two, the back end at the side. You know where it says love every step?
Yeah.
That doesn't slide at all. No, it was a bit hard to see from here whether it did or not.
So from the outside, you can't actually see the yellow legs, can you? From here?
Yeah,
over there. Are they stored on the body itself?
Yeah. Yeah, they lift up.
Yeah.
But whereabouts? Or is it hidden from view?
When the van goes under it, the front lift up this way, the back lift up that way.
The legs push in.
Yeah, yeah.
The legs push in because they have to come out so the vehicle can get underneath it.
Yeah, but as the vehicle is going back under, are the legs in the way?
No, because the legs pull out either side.
The legs are wider than the vehicle. Got
yeah,
it.
And then when the vehicle's under and it lifts it up, because you raise and lower the suspension on the vehicle.
Oh dear.
Yeah, so you lower the suspension back under it, lift it up, and then once it's lifted and the weight's off the legs push in and then lift up out the way.
So, do you know why this company has chosen that particular trailer? What's the benefit in your eyes?
I'm not too sure, mate.
Never would you really agree asked. It's a bit unusual?
Tufnells use like these all the time.
Yeah, normally they're just trailers, aren't they, with wheels on?
Yeah, that one's one of our intercompanies.
Sorry?
That's an intercompany one. If it comes from somewhere else, they drop it off here and we'll fill it up throughout the day. Then right. They take it back to their place, drop another one off for us.
But your colleague said they're all demountable. What, these ones? I thought only the one on the right is. Would you agree?
All these ones here,
yeah.
Parts up, they're not demountable.
The one on the right is? No, not that right.
Number
four.
Next to the white van.
On that side?
AV17...
NAE.
Yeah, that's a demountable, surely.
I mean, they're free. That one is
coming. So you would agree with me then? The three to the left are fixed. And number four is demountable.
Yeah.
Yeah. See? He said...
It's a different kind of cab as well, look, if you look.
So even somebody here is confused about it. It's not only me. So I feel a bit better now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because this is all being recorded and I don't want to make myself sound stupid. So the first guy...
I make myself look stupid all the time, mate.
The first guy is also stupid. No, there we go. So, what's your job here, mate?
I'm a supervisor.
Oh, right. So you've got the authority then?
To let us on and have
right.
a look around.
Where's the visitor's book?
I can't do that.
I'll just give you one piece of information, right? Free advertising is guaranteed, isn't it?
I know. But I know what you're saying. I've seen
can
videos
people,
and everything.
Can people go onto your website and buy?
Buy?
Yeah. So, the viewers, is there a possibility that a viewer of... video that we could create, is there a possibility that they could go on and buy something from your website?
If you make an account.
But that's possible, isn't it?
That is possible.
So it's now or never, what are you going to say, yes or no? It's up to you.
The final say is not with me.
Do you want to check?
I can ask him, mate. See.
10 minutes and we'll be gone, it's up to you.
I'll go and ask him, mate.
We won't be coming on anyway, mate, alright? Unless you authorise us to do so. There we go.
Please.
We've left it with him, PJ.
That's right.
And if they seize the moment, great for them. If not,
that's
we've
it.
Got a lovely video with a lovely chat with two great guys.
That's it.
And we've all learnt about demountable trailers now. Well, I have anyway.
I was going to say, I knew about them.
Yeah, you knew about them anyway. There we go. Demountable. Because we can see the steel there. That is
the steel runner.
Runner. That is obviously required to go along the chassis. But from the front, they all look very similar, don't they?
It's a shame you're not going to get a chance to watch one of them demount a trailer.
Yeah. And it might seem sad to some people, but this is something different that I've not seen before.
Yeah.
And it's quite interesting. Now, the product that's on there, would you say that's turf?
I would say that it's either carpets or artificial grass.
Well, look at this here. That looks like underlay to me.
Could be. A bit difficult to see from here, isn't it?
And that says...
Is it Spanish? Andale?
Well, that one says M-A-P-E-I. But anyway, I think I have seen all I can see from the ground. I'm going to seize this opportunity to get David up and see what this place looks like from above!
And I think I might just do the same as you and get the old dread drone out. I just don't want to get too close to those big aeroplanes coming past. Right, we are in a safe place to fly. We've already checked that. So up we go. Right, so we can see all the vehicles here. We're only at 40 foot, probably about 13 metres, so we're not particularly high. and we've got the loading base there, and then that's the warehouse entrance. Let's have a look what's around this corner that we can't see so good. There we go. I think we'll go up just a bit more. Have a look around the other side of the building. Now, around the other side of a building, there's the shop that's open to the public. So here, we have a shop. Let's just move the drone back a bit. See if we can get a better view. There we go, there's the shop, look. And staff car park by the look of it. So it looks like they've got a one-way system here. Goods in this side and out the other side, I think. I'm not sure. But the vehicle that's just pipped to me was the one where the driver was talking to us. So I'm assuming that is, no, he can't get out this way. Must just have been somebody that knows us then. Unless you can get out round the back. I don't think so. No. So in and out here, and the other entrance is purely for cars and smaller vehicles. So it looks like everything comes here, is sorted and then dispatched out to shops and things like that, I would say, the way that they were talking. So it's like a distribution hub. Right, so let's have a look at getting the baby back. Down she comes. Yes, good looking fella, that's me. Legs like tree trunks. Right, so we've got two key rings here. We've got a PJ and a DJ Audits key ring. Hidden on this tree just here at the side of the goods in at Hadfield's, the floor covering specialists. So that's where we hid. Right, everybody, that concludes our visit to Hadfield's. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, please share, please subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Bye, everybody. See you soon.